Hello everyone and welcome to Gob's Haven. In this video, I will feature a Tuya Smart pH and nutrient controller. Before I go on, thanks to my maybe 10 YouTube subscribers and to our Facebook followers, I am doing this video documentation once again primarily for myself because I tend to forget all my engineering works after a year or two. If you find this useful, thanks. In this video, I am showing you the update on my automation project. The electrical wiring is newly upgraded to ensure safety. This is complete with documentations in case someone would have to do the troubleshooting without me, they would find it easier to do the task. Previously, Tuya temp and humidity sensor implementation in my greenhouse is shown. For today, I am showing you the pH and electroconductivity or EC controller I have just installed. EC is basically the same measurement significance as PPM. We only divide the EC value by 2. That's the PPM. For some reason, controllers with PPM is slightly expensive compared to the one that I have here. So that is why I have the EC sensor instead of the one that displays PPM. The controller has its temperature sensor as well, although for now, I use that figure just for monitoring purposes only. My probes are located here. I installed a DIY chamber with its own sampling pump, so I monitor the pH and EC 24/7 that whenever I check, I always get the correct value. How does the automation work, you may ask? For my PPM or EC monitoring, I set the system to run either the water dosing pump or the nutrient dosing pump depending on the measured value. My target is to keep 550 PPM. Equivalent to 1100 EC value. Anything lower, it means I need to pump nutrients. I set the value to 700 ppm. That's the upper value, equivalent to 1400 EC. It means that when I get 1400 and above, water dosing will activate. Similarly, pH monitoring is done in such a way that if I have 7, my pH down pump will run to bring it down to 5.5. I do not consider pH up because in this farm, I never had an issue with my nutrients turning too acidic or pH going down. For my system safety, I have a float sensor that detects if my service tank is already full. When it does, all the pump will stop dosing. Behind this greenhouse, I put my nutrient tank and my water tank that gets checked every day and filled if necessary. All dosing is done automatically on my buckets and NFT systems. The implementation significantly reduces my workforce to 50%. And the best part, I can monitor this greenhouse even without going here and letting my housemates do all the planting and harvesting job and minimal intervention. This greenhouse is also equipped with an HD camera for remote crop inspection.